Ladies and gentlemen, our next bout this evening in professional women's competition, Helen Moore, welterweight division. Our first bout of the weight of Beijing to the new one, Marcus
Aren't you?
Yeah, I mean, I've watched Ali from the start of his career. I've always, you know, been very impressed with his wrestling. I've made given constructive criticism about, you know, the style of his fighting, and he, you know, I think he's took that on board from people. And Ali now has got to one of the best fighters in the UK.
I'm very, very surprised he's not being picked up by a big show. Like, you know, he's not signed to Cage Warriors. He's not signed to UFC. He's still fighting on very local shows.
I mean, he had the one fight at Cage Warriors and lost, didn't he, I think?
Jack Hermanson KO'd him, unfortunately. But Ali Arish has spotted a very, very, very good record of 18-2. He's got KO power. He's got possibly the best wrestling in UK MMA. He's got a very improved finishing ability. Fighting out of the fight factory with Andrew defending his corner. He's looking quite lean.
Yeah, I thought in his last couple of fights he's very, very lean. A little bit light, because he used to be sort of in between middle and welter and quite stocky.
Definitely, definitely looking like he's lost a bit of weight. He's looking a lot leaner than he normally does. Now the only criticism I've got of Ali is he's got very suspect stamina. So I'd be very interested to see if this goes three rounds.
Here's a record of 5 wins, 3 losses, no draws. Fighting out of London, Marcus Maxim. And across the cage in the record, this man is 28 years of age. He stands 5 feet, 8 inches tall, and weighing at 77 kilograms.
Ali Arish always brings a big support, massive, massive fan base, massive following.
Yeah, certainly. I think Ali's going to show, you know, his stand-up's improved greatly. And I think, you know, if this fight had been 3 years ago, we'd say, yeah, Ali's going to come out, go for a takedown. I think he's going to probably stand up for a bit
first. He's got very, very heavy hands. And
yeah, solid shots.
Wrestling base where he sits low and he just powers everything through his back legs. But, I mean, I don't think he's very... He's got a very good chin as well. Considering he's only been KO'd once in his career, and he's got a very, very, very good chin. Straight bullies him straight into the cage.
Yeah, the last place you want to be is in a clinch with Ali Arish.
Well, any close distance against Ali Arish, you kind of need to... He's looking, he's got that.
And he's got him up against the fence.
He's not using that, Maxson isn't using that underhook at all. And he's looking to take him down against the cage. He's got one underhook and he's just kind of monitoring the hips and the legs there on that left hand side.
Chopping in little knees just to weaken up the base.
Now the thing is with this is, it's interesting that Ali does this because at will, Ali will take down anybody in the first three to five minutes of the fight.
I think he's tiring him out. You know, you can really drain an opponent by holding up against the fence, making them sort of fight to stay up.
I'm very interested as to what he's trying to do here because he could just take him down and finish him. He's got that sort of finishing ability.
He's talking to him there, I don't know what he's saying.
He's got that underhook. They're just kind of stalemating at the moment, jockeying for position. Nice left body shot there. I'd like to see a little bit more work. Maybe Ali just digging in that left underhook and kind of lift picking his opponent up. And Maxson just looking for the takedown himself, and that was a nice finish. And I'm being looked
at. Ali holding it, and he's took Ali down. Now, that's interesting.
I'm a little shocked why how that happened. And he's got Ali's back.
I'd love to see a suplex now.
That'd be very interesting. He's just on a little shoulder bump there. He's looking for a little short, choppy elbows to kind of shake him off the back. Shooting three shots to the legs there.
So Ali Arish defending against the fence isn't something we see often.
Now he takes the back. He's looking for that what we call seatbelt position to before he gets the hooks in, establishes the hooks. He's not doing much from there. Ali's using the cage to smear Maxson off his back.
Well, this isn't what we expected.
Not at all. I expected it the other way around with Ali pressing his opponent up against the cage.
And do we remember the last Lithuanian that came up here to fight Ali Arish?
Godzilla.
Godzilla. Again, our attempt to wrestle Ali.
Well, they did very well. It
was the first time I was actually refereeing that fight. First time I've seen Ali get a takedown.
You've got Maxson pressing Ali up against the cage, using his weight very well. But I'm wondering how much energy he's wasting here by kind of constantly changing that pressure. Beautiful, beautiful.
Yes, slams him with a takedown.
And he's still got Ali's back. And I'm very surprised with these Antonios guys because every now and again you do come out with one with a diamond in the rough where you've got these guys with. Oh, he tags him slightly with a left hand. Maxson moving around, looking to change his levels.
Now we can see Ali landing some shots. I think. Oh,
look
at that!
Beautiful right hand, and that's the power we were talking about. He's holding his head. He wasn't. He didn't like that at all.
Yeah, he really has caught him with that shot.
Takedown.
And Ali sprawl. He slams his head straight into the mat.
That was definitely a desperation shot. He did not want to stand there and get tagged by Ali. Ali clears the hand. He can look to move over to the right-hand side, circle off to Ali's right, and he can take side ride. Maxson scrambling.
Oh, Ali's looking for a big shot. Ali's going to finish this, I think.
Ali's got very heavy hands when he wants to be. He grabs hold of a single, finishes it, straight into side control.
Yeah, I'd watch Ali now start to really ground and pound his opponent.
Pushes the head down, maybe looking for a north-south choke.
You do not want to be stuck underneath Ali Arish like this. It is such a solid base.
Maxson grabbing hold of that leg. It was more to kind of protect himself as opposed to letting advanced position. It's more out of desperation and survival more than anything. Ali chopping away.
It looks like he's given up a little here. It's hard for Ali to land anything really because obviously he can't punch the back of the head.
Shots to the back of the head there. Now, after Maxson at that right hand, that's when everything changed. He's got hold of, if you look at that, just the way he's got hold of the left ankle, I love that because it stops him from kind of stepping up and tripoding onto that leg to stand up like he is doing now. And he's still got hold of that single.
Great wrestling from both guys. Look at Ali looking for that
I'd
shot.
I'd like to see Ali throw some knees. Maxson's ducking his head and like to see him throw some knees maybe. Sprawl out again. That was so predictable.
Sprawl uppercut. Sprawl nice. Now.
Maxson's looking desperate at the moment. He's still very much in this fight if he really wanted to. Nice little takedown with ankle pick.
We'll look at Ali controlling the head. Powering the shots in.
He could just push the head down and bail out.
Look how relaxed Ali is there for the takedown. It's just a great experience.
And he's tapped. Hammer fist to the side of the head. I enjoyed that fight. I did. First couple of minutes.
Very, very good fight, you know. Very different skill range. It's good for Ali to fight these different guys with different skills. Again, come through. What a win.
I think Ali was definitely surprised.
I think we're all surprised.
Stop writing all the wrestlers. They used to be like, what the hell is it? Because I thought.
Ladies and gentlemen,